This year, Apple released three Apple Watches at its Apple event. There are Apple Watch Ultra, Apple Watch Series 8, and the second generation of Apple Watch SE. The brand new Apple Watch Ultra can support up to 36 hours of battery life, and the Series 8 and second generation of SE maintain the original battery life. So, we're gonna test their charging performance and see which one is the best. Firstly, let's briefly introduce them. The Ultra has the largest display than Series 8 and SE. The Ultra also has a larger battery, so it's much thicker than the other two. There is an additional orange customizable button. Flip to the back. Since they have different sensors, the back is also slightly different. Only the circular area in the middle of SE is black. We also found that the original chargers from those three Apple Watches are slightly different. The SE has a regular plastic charger and cannot support fast charging. The Series 8 comes with a metal fast charger, while the charger of Ultra comes with a woven cable. After the brief introduction, we know that Ultra has the largest battery capacity, and only SE cannot support fast charging. Next, let's test it out to see their actual performance. We'll charge them with an Apple 18W charger from 0 to 100%. Firstly, the charging voltage of SE is pretty stable at 5 volts, and the power is about 2 watts for the first 21 minutes, and the current will constantly fluctuate during that period. The power drops to 1.5 watts in 1 hour and 24 minutes, and it takes about 1 hour and 34 minutes to be fully charged. Then let's move to Series 8. The display lights up at 8 minutes, and the power increases to 4.4 watts. And then the current fluctuates between 15 to 30 minutes, the peak power is about 4.9 watts in 24 minutes, and it takes about 1 hour and 6 minutes to be fully charged, almost half an hour faster than SE. Finally, here is the charging curve of the Apple Watch Ultra. The current fluctuation is the largest among three devices, and the power fluctuates with the current. The peak power is about 5 watts, and it drops to 4.3 and 3 watts at 43 and 57 minutes. Due to the current fluctuation, the charging time of Ultra is 6 minutes slower than Series 8. We can see the obvious differences when we put the charging data of all three Apple Watches in the same graph. Since the SE does not support fast charging, it's the slowest. The Series 8 supports fast charging, and its battery capacity is smaller than the Ultra, so the charging speed is the fastest. But the Ultra is just 6 minutes slower than Series 8. Series 8 can go from 0 to 80% in about 41 minutes, and the Ultra can go from 0 to 80% in about 52 minutes, almost the same as what Apple claims. We also tried to use three different original chargers to charge the Ultra, and we found that their charging speeds are different. For example, it takes 1 hour and 44 minutes to charge with the Series 8 original charger, and 2 hours and 49 minutes to charge with the SE2 original charger. So a fast charger for Apple Watch is indispensable. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you want to see the charging test of other products, you can leave your comments down below. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!